relaxation to begin. Separate the feet to a comfortable distance apart. Place one hand over the other on the low abdomen. And let your eyes close, and let them close in a soft way, not a hard closing. You can have your lips lightly sealed and teeth gently meshed together if you like. Begin with a focus on the breath. Breathe in through the nose. Breathe out through the nose as well. Breathe in deeply. Breathe out slowly. Be relaxed. And begin to imagine that cascade of relaxation that flows down the body. Imagine it beginning at the top of the head, going down to the bottoms of the feet. Feel the face relax, the muscles around the jaw, around the eyes. Allow the neck to relax. Feel some of the tension leave your upper back and chest. Feel the shoulders, arms, and hands relax. There you go. Relax the stomach, relax the low back. Relax the waist and the ribs. Feel the cascade of relaxation. Continue into the thighs, the backs of the legs relaxing. Allow your knees to soften. And relax the calves, the ankles, and the feet. And with your next exhale, release by lowering your hands, opening your eyes. Separate your feet to the shoulder width distance. Turn the toes in so the outside edges of the feet come parallel. Circle the arms as you sit back. Allow the legs to bend and feel the pelvis tuck under, rotating slightly the direction a dog would tuck its tail. Be very aware of the feeling of the weight in your feet. Round your knees out and sit back until you can feel most of the weight in the heels and outside edges of the feet. If you're barefoot, you'll be able to keep the feet from rolling up maybe a little more easily than you would in these shoes with the rounded bottoms, with the rounded soles. Hold about 2 more minutes. Breathe in deeply, breathe out slowly. shoulders, drop elbows. It's a good idea to remember in your Nei Kung and in your Tai Chi. Continue to hold. I'm going to walk off camera for a second. Continue to hold. We'll hold about 30 more seconds. And okay, release. Straighten the legs. Lower the hands. Circle the arms up, breathe in, push palms down, breathe out. Okay, second posture, ride the wild horse, bring the feet in a little closer. Begin, breathe in, let the arms circle up. Feel your feet remain relaxed on the floor. Breathe out as you bend forward, tuck the pelvis, bend the legs slowly. Controlled sinking. Keep your weight concentrated in the heels and outside edges of the feet without the feet coming up. Inhale, push. Exhale, arms come down. Look for the feeling of the whole body connected even when the arms just move down. Two in the middle distance, inhale. Exhale. You can think of that same head suspended feeling here as in other postures. Breathe in, push, come up slowly. Try to keep the abdomen relaxed for that same kind of breath. Exhale. A small distance, bring the feet in close. Toes would touch, but the outside, but the heels would be a little bit apart, so the outside edges of the feet would be parallel. Relax the feet, feel the body connected and upright without any excess tension holding you like rigid, relaxed and connected. Inhale. Feel the breath connect to the arm. Exhale, bend forward, sink. Just keep the feet from moving and sink down slowly, finding your low limit within those constraints, with the right alignment of the knees. Inhale, push. Exhale, arms. Two, inhale. Exhale. Inhale. Exhale. And large distance is just back to your shoulder width. Ride the wild horse, large distance, begin, breathe in. Draw the breath through the whole way up. Fill the lungs at the top, hold for just a second, begin to exhale, then forward, let the air out evenly as you go down. You're not forcing the air out, it's kind of like air would just come out of an inflated balloon. Finish breathing out, inhale, push. Let's do one more, inhale. Exhale. Inhale, push up. Exhale down. Playing guitar, posture three. I'll turn this time instead of facing you. Turn the left toes out, 60 degrees. Shift your weight into the left leg. Circle the arms, set your right heel in front. Left hand by the right elbow, and hold there. Continue to hold, and I'll turn and show you from the side. Continue. 90% of the weight in the back leg, the left leg. Bent knee. 10% in the front leg, the right leg. Straight knee. Continuing the slow deep breath. And release, come out. Okay, I'll face the correct way for this other side. Turn the right toes out 60 degrees. Shift your weight to the right leg. Circle your arms, set the left heel in front. Right hand by left elbow. Again, sit 90% of that weight back. And push 10% into your front leg, into your left. Continue to hold just a little longer. I'll show you from the side again. And release. Okay. Shake it out. Number four, the compass. Go back to your shoulder width, outside edge of the feet parallel. And begin with a nice even stretch through the body. Feel the feet remain relaxed on the floor. Gently extended through all parts. Straining in no parts. And one, go to your right. Look towards the hands. Maintain the evenly stretched feeling through the body. Throughout all the parts of the posture. Two, relax your upper body down over the right foot. Palms face the foot, fingers pointing towards each other. And three, reach straight forward. Upper body coming parallel to the floor, fingers stretch. Four, down over the left foot. Five, roll to the left. Roll through a side bend and gently lean back. Allow your knees to bend. Allow your hips to come forward. Push up through the chest. And go easy. Don't strain. Six, roll back out to your right. Feeling the lower back release as you get to the side. And then seven, back up to the top. Okay. Other way to the left. One. Two, down over the left side. Feel the weight of your upper body doing the work. bend in your elbows, same alignment of the palms, fingers, etc. Three, reach straight forward, upper body parallel to the floor. And four, down over the right side. Six, roll to the right, through the side bend, gently lean back. Six, roll back out to your left side bend. And seven, back up to the top. To release, slide the hands down. All right, good. Number five, double dragon's leap from the sea. Back to your shoulder width as a starting position. Turn your left toes out 45 degrees. Step your right foot straight forward. Notice I kept the shoulder width. You can always tell from the camera now that I'm not on the tightrope. Hands in the push position. Do you remember the bonus for this one? Imagine the headlamps on the hips pointing forward that don't turn off to the side as you go forward and back. Begin with a stretch. Even now, see if you can feel the hips not turning. Oh, and by the way, feel your upper body not turning because the hips aren't turning. Stretch. Form the circle with the arms. Begin, come back up, push position. Nice and slow, full inhale. Exhale, back. Inhale. Slow ones, breathe in, breathe out. Last slow one, breathe in. Now some quick ones, breathe out, breathe in, breathe out, breathe in, breathe out, breathe in, and release. Be careful, if going as quickly as I'm going feels like it might injure you, back off and just go when you're more comfortable. Other side from your shoulder width. Turn the right toes out 45 degrees, step the left foot forward, and shift forward to your push position on the other side. Push position, the feeling of the back leg pretty straight, front leg bent. And remember the hips. Don't turn, stretch. Now your right hand to the knee, left to the ankle. Form the circle with the arms. Move with your breath. Breathe in. Up and push. And back. Breathe out. Move together. Inhale. Exhale. Inhale. Exhale. Continue. Breathe out. Breathe in. Breathe out. In, last slow one. And more quick. Exhale. Inhale. Exhale. Inhale. Exhale. Saying it out loud. Number six, rhinoceros gazes at the moon. Separate the feet shoulder width. Outside edges parallel. Bend the knees, circle the arms. Right above left. Look for a feeling of evenness before you begin. Feel even weight between the feet. This feeling will change as you put more of your body weight over one foot or the other. Feel the knees out, the pelvis tucked. And from the tucked pelvis up to the top of the head, the idea of the head suspended. Keep most of that stuff the same. Bend forward, turn to your right. Extend your right arm and look up under the arm. Center. Right hand comes up under left, rock back upright in the upper body. And all that stuff about feeling centered, try to reset all that before you go the other way. Forward, turn to your left. And yeah, you'll feel a little more weight in your left foot. Feel both feet stay connected, both knees stay bent. The weight's still concentrated in the heel and outside edge of each foot. And back. And right. And back. And left. Yeah, release. Straighten the legs. Lower the hands. Did I mention loosen the waist? Loosen the waist. Okay, number 7. Ride the tiger. I'm going to turn the other way for this one, too. Hands on the hips. If you're facing forward towards your screen, turn left 45 degrees. Sink a little bit. We talked a bit about this with the tuck, right? Get the tuck. Step straight forward with the right foot. Step out, turn your shoulders to the front. Shift forward a little bit, push off these small steps. Other way. To the right, 45 degrees, hands on the hips. Sink and tuck. Step with the left. Find your even bend between both knees. Turn your shoulders to the front. Go forward a little bit. Push off the small steps. All the way back together. Other way. Sink. Step out with the right. Turn the shoulders. Breathe deeply. Forward and up. Turn right. Sink. Step with the left. Keep both knees out, keep the toes and hips pointed 45 degrees or as close as you can. And the shoulders turn. And shoulders turning, lean the waist turns. Forward and push off. If you need to do more of those, you can always hit pause, do a few more, and then resume. Here we are, number 8, Phoenix spreads wings. Separate the feet, middle distance, sink, right, relax the arms, circle back up and forward. not holding your breath, breathe deeply. Try some more quickly. Go easy. And release. Slowly the other way, forward, up, back, down. You might recall from lat sash training the things about the legs pumping, the hips rocking, the tuck remaining tucked, the legs never straightening, the arms, shoulders staying relaxed. That was kind of too fast for slow ones. Sorry about that. Let's do some fast ones now. And release. Okay, number 9, which we'll cover in lat sash training today. I'm going to turn for this one again. Feet start together. Turn the right toes out a little. Sink down and step out to your right. And just a little bit forward. Make fists, right one by the temple, left by the chest. And bend your right leg, look over the left shoulder. And push off. Let's do 2 more to the right. Tiger, not right, the tiger, hit the tiger, right. And up. All right, let's go the other way. Turn the left toes out, sink. Step to the left and a little bit forward. Left fist by the temple, then the left leg, look over the right shoulder. Last one, hit the tiger to the left, and step. And okay. So, we'll take a look at that one from different angles after we bow out basic training today. Number 10, owl turns head, separate the feet shoulder width apart. Outside edges parallel, if you hadn't guessed it, hands on the hips. Sink down. Round the knees out, tuck the pelvis under. Before we begin turning, look for a spine neutral feeling. So, from the tucked pelvis to the top of the head, the chin slightly tucked. You can imagine that lengthened, unstrained spinal cord, spinal column. Slowly turn just the head to the right. Center. And really straighten the legs, lower the hands. Circle the arms up, breathe in. Push palms down, breathe out. All right, just a minute or two over for basic training. But we will bow out and work on our lat sash training after that. All right, hope you got some good feeling stretching, breathing, working on your Tai Chi, maybe a little bit of a little bit of meditative sort of thing, even if it was the only time it happened today. Bow out our basic training. And we follow the 5 hearts. Faith, respect, perseverance, patience, and humility. All right, basic training dismissed.